Legislative Council, and Mrs. Wendy Thompson, representing the War Widows Guild of Australia. Mr. John Robertson, MP, New South Wales Opposition Leader. Councillor Clover Moore, Lord Mayor of Sydney. Honourable Katrina Hutchinson, Minister for Planning, Industry and Small Business, New South Wales Government. Rear Admiral Tim Barrett, Commander of the Australian Fleet, representing the Chief of the Defence Force. Major General Paul Brereton, representing the Vice Chief of the Defence Force. Major General Nick Slater, Commander of Forces Command. And Air Commodore Gary Martin, representing the Air Commander of Australia. Commissioner Andrew Scipioni, Commissioner of Police. Assistant Commissioner Stuart Mitchell, representing the Commissioner of Rural Fire Services. Assistant Commissioner Greg Newton, representing the Commissioner of State Emergency Services. Commissioner Gregory Mullins, Commissioner of New South Wales Fire and Rescue. And Deputy Commissioner Mike Willis, representing the Commissioner for Ambulance Service. These will now be led by representatives of the governments of Commonwealth countries and the Consular Corps of New South Wales. Representatives of New South Wales branches of Ed Service and related organisations, associations, charities and religious organisations. ladies and gentlemen, that concludes the replay for the moment. The ode will now be delivered by Mr. Don Rowe, OAM, New South Wales State President of the Return and Services League of Australia, followed by the sounding of the last post. 1 minute silence will then be observed at 11 o'clock. Ladies and gentlemen, would you please stand?
Staunch to the end against odds uncounted, they fell with their faces to the foe. They shall grow not old as weak the left rower. Age shall not weary them, nor the years can bend. At the going down of the sun and in the morning, we will remember them. Lest we forget.
Services and related organizations. associations, charities and religious organisations to lay their wreaths down. Mr Michael Clark, New South Wales and Australia cricket captain, and Mr Alistair Cook, England and Wales cricket captain. SMRAMR.
Selfishly given before. 6 Australians were killed
and 4 wounded.
Within a few weeks, most of the German territories in the area had been occupied without further opposition. The success to this point represented Australia's first substantial military achievement as an independent nation, but it did not come without further cost. The success of the operation was marked by the disappearance of submarine AE-1 off the coast of New Guinea. This was the first Royal Australian Navy unit lost in wartime. No trace of the submarine or its 35-man crew had ever been found. At a memorial service in Wollongong for Captain Brian Hockley, Reverend Len Smith, rector of St Andrew's Church of England, said, "We have given our best in a noble and righteous cause. Such lives are a part of the price we have to pay in maintaining the traditions of all that is best of the British nation. Great Britain is engaged in this war in order to maintain peace and honour and to protect those who had failed to protect in the hour of their need. As Australians, we must be prepared to pay the price if we are a call, if we are sharing the call to do so righteous cause." And so it remains. Let us today reflect, remember and honour Abel Stephen Bill Williams. Today, let us reflect, remember and honour one of our own from Sydney, Captain Brian Hockley. Let us reflect, remember and honour 102,000 Australians who have made a supreme sacrifice for a righteous cause for their country. We will remember.
Admiral Gates, thank you for those words. I now invite the lectern, Chaplain Cole Acton, to deliver a prayer for all ADF personnel serving overseas.
May God, our ruler and guide, in whose hands are the destinies of this and every nation, we give you thanks for the freedoms that we enjoy in this land. We thank you for those who've laid down their lives to defend our country. We pray for our sailors, soldiers and airmen currently serving overseas in many places, but particularly in Afghanistan and in the waters of the Gulf of Oman and Somalia, as we continue to watch over and protect them. We pray that all people of Australia may gratefully remember their courage and sacrifice. And may we all have the grace to live in a spirit of justice, generosity and peace. We ask this through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen.
Ladies and gentlemen, sadly, today's inclement weather has robbed us of the presence and company of the Royal Australian Navy Band and also the Sydney Mail Choir, so we have been forced to somewhat abbreviate today's ceremony. Would you please stand now as the Catafalque Party from the Royal Australian Navy is about to dismount from the centre. Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, we have now reached the conclusion of this morning's ceremony. Everyone is invited.